Honorable Special Secretary, Mr. Sivashalam. Secretary TRI, Mr. Guptaji. And Architect of Future Network, Mr. Anuj Jain. And other CGM, BSNL, Mr. Piyush Kare. And I think the people who actually led all of us to come here, Stevie Ramachandran and from Bharat the Exhibition team. So I think, ladies and gentlemen, very warm welcome and very good morning to all of you. I've been in this industry for the last 25 years, and my today experience is quite different. Let me tell you that. And TV actually made my day. I've been waiting for this day for the last 25 years. When will this day will come? When I can see people, about 200, 300 people sitting in the room, only talking and thinking about what fiber can do miracles. I remember, I know I've been with Reliance quite many years. We partnered with them. We were the last person to be called for discussions. And I used to wait for 3 days to get an appointment. Those were the years when we passed through telling what fiber means. Today, I'm very happy to see that National Digital Communication Policy, which is made available to all of us with a great leadership under Mrs. Sivashalam and Mrs. Aruna Sundarajan. And talking about fiber first as a policy, I think that's a great journey, I would say. We must give a great compliment. And also talking about most of the service providers that we do in globally, including India, people talk about fiber now needed everywhere. There is no other option. So that is something that I was thinking that when I was asked to come here and speak a few things, I thought it's anyway Fibre to the Conference, FTTh, second edition of 2018. And there are a lot of interesting sessions during the day. But then I realized that the policy, what is it, I think, put before us, is a very, very ambitious policy. And it requires a lot of efforts from both policymakers, industries, association like us, and ecosystem to make this policy implemented in a very effective way. Otherwise, we have several such policies in the past. I think implementation has actually not taken the right spirit. But we cannot miss that opportunity this time. If you are really responsible for the next generation to create a different experience to the people, this national digital communication policy can actually change life experience of every citizen in the country. That becomes a very big responsibility of the entire industry. And of course, Jio Giga Fiber is leading that, and we have seen a lot of government programs happening around that. But industry all need to come together to see this fiber to the exponential, what we talk about. It can actually create huge level of... I'm going to take you through, if you can just... some of the interesting, I'm sorry, I think you are not able to see that. Maybe if you want to shift to that side. You want to go down and maybe it's interesting statistics to see. Mr. Sivashalam, if you... I think it's difficult to turn around and see if you can... Sorry for that. Okay. So, I think we all know about it. I think we have experienced in one of the Jio's mornings show, they were talking about what all these extended applications actually take us through. There is what you see in the screen is very limited. There is much more to do. All of them actually, as Mr. Anujan said, increasing the complexity of the scale and the latency required, the bandwidth and latency required, and with coupled with an agility and the scale that is probably becoming the need of the hour is hyperscale network. It's not just applications which is going to, I think we know how one of the large telco in India has actually unshackled the data demand in the country. We have seen that, and it's still growing, it's just continuing. It's not just applications. It gets more, I think, interesting when you see devices getting added. 3 times devices getting added, you get number of users getting added 3 times every month. And you find an interesting thing that a critical mass for India. As Ms. Piyush Kare said, Bharat Desh, I think it's a place where you can actually create a scale, 1.3 billion people. When you all add all of things, this actually becomes a most complex way to build an hyperscale network. And that's where I think we see as an industry that a lot of, I think, disruptions are taking place. Everyone, I think, including telcos, including companies who involved in this process, actually trying to see how you can disrupt existing networks, existing technologies, to really bring something that we can actually deliver this. We all know that data bits are going to triple. I think that's what Mr. Anuj said. I think there is a huge amount of need. We find that there is a need for telcos and all other providers thinking about how the new networks can be created. And a lot of value migration is happening. You find now people moving from a simple hardware to software-driven controls. And I think people taking the most of into cloud and analytics, this is the life. And I think new revenue models are coming. The platform as a service is becoming a very interesting model to see. But if this is a situation that is going to be before us for the next 10 years, is our current network designs and topology may not be sufficient enough? I think there is a need. I think I must compliment some of the, including Jio. Everyone is actually thinking out of the box. And they're trying to challenge the current status, look at what else to be the next way of next generation networks. And we find it interesting that this collaborative moment which is getting created today between large telcos, including ecosystem, is actually giving new ideas, new way to build next generation networks. That's a very interesting point to see. I think from our standpoint of view, I think we have seen networks were built which are very complex, not very cost effective, primarily because they're mostly driven in wireless backhaul, very customized hardware, and also proprietary software has been the predominantly the way to design network. And we start seeing the shift happening now, very big shift, which we speak, we know from since beginning, most of the speakers talking about fiber is everywhere today. I think it is now fiber will be a dominant in the network design. We see, I think, mostly customized hardware moving into open source, commoditized, virtualized hardware, which is very critical for the scale that we're talking. If you don't deal this problem or don't deal this transformation, probably we'll not be able to reach the scale that we're talking about. I think software is also moving from a vendor towards vendor neutral software-driven networks. I think that's what we see, and this, we see a lot of activities around this, including Sterlite actually takes active participation. So I'll come to this. I think there's something we know. I fully agree with Mr. Piyush Kare, the way I think he has put. When I read this policy, I think I thought someone, I think, has put in tremendous amount of efforts and even the mind share in creating this national digital communication policy. And it's not only a couple of lines he mentioned. I think when I read it, it actually gives a passion. It gives a commitment to do something because it is actually clearly articulated towards a new India, a new telecom communication infrastructure or a digital infrastructure for India, which can actually become a role model for the many countries. I think this is set very well. I think it is revolving around three principles. I think they are very well articulated. There are certain large aspirations and targets for what is India should be in next 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. But important thing which has been articulated in this policy, I must emphasize, I think a lot of, including Broadband India Forum has made significant impact inputs to that, is how do we propel this ambition, right? It is a goal is always good to have, but unless you look at some of the basic policy issues, bringing broadband as an infrastructural, you know, giving that essential status to it, and also a lot of license reforms in the country which are required to make this digital communication policy happening, and also encouraging local manufacturing, promoting research and development in the country, which is critical for the success of this policy to be implemented. I think when I look at it, it is a great initiative. It needs, in my view, a strong collaboration on a continuous ongoing basis between government policy and industry to further actually work towards making this process, this policy to be implemented, which is, we all know that there are a lot of focus required in process simplification. We also need to have stringent compliance of these policies. And also, I think we need to bring a lot of technology innovation to make this desire or a goal to happen. And we all said that fiber is needed everywhere, but we're still a long way to go in India. If you look at, somebody spoke about we don't have enough fiber laid in the country, and if you just see the statistics, I think this is just comparing to United States and China. If you are to go to that level of a connectivity, you have to almost scale up 15x in terms of your connectivity in the country. If you look back last 20 years, the kind of network that probably all of us have put together, including a lot of networks coming from Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, followed by the large telcos, we would have deployed about 2 million kilometers of cable in 20 years. And some of it is actually not traceable today. We don't know where it is. That's a problem that we have. If you are to really look at what Mr. Anuj Jain said, what NDCP policy crafted by Mr. Shivashalim, if that has to happen, we have to deploy 3 million kilometers of cable in the next 5 years. Imagine this complexity. You have to do 5 times faster. Time is only 3 to 5 years to make this policy happen. How is that possible? You look at India has several challenges. It's short of a slide to show, but there are many things that require significant changes and challenges that we need to address. I think this is the problem that we have in the country, that if you have to build a network of this scale, we have to think about something out of the box, something that you need to bring some best practices. From our experience, we find that there are 5 challenges that probably are actually going to impede this entire network creation in the country, which is very important for both policymakers, industry, as well as ecosystem to address. And all of them actually have a significant impact on the network scale that we are going to build. There's a lot on the slide, but I would like to say that each of these challenges, if you don't address, probably will impede the pace at the scale at which networks are to be built. For example, we have multiple approvals. And in our experience, it actually cuts down the time of execution to twice, which is needed. You actually spend double the time. And you have, we were walking through some of the stalls in the morning, we found one stall was talking about GIS systems. I think a lot of information that is available underground today, it is not available to us. And we actually go to the network and dig the road, then we find we are actually cutting somebody else's utility. And to revert back the situation takes more time than building a new network. So how about creating that database? Because this is a significant challenge that we face in creating network. And somebody talked in the morning that the best way is to make automation, but still, these kind of networks will be built by people. Unless people are skilled enough, you cannot achieve the space at which the networks to be built. A lot of, I think, Indian practices about manual planning, legacy operation, all of this required, they all impact the speed and scale at which these networks to be built. We strongly believe that, I think, as an industry working together with government and policymakers with large telco operators, there are certain solutions possible. But I think it would only come by very collaborative working, because it's like one stakeholder alone cannot do it. We've been doing that. I think we will be doing one Maharashtra net network for Maharashtra for entire statewide connectivity to Gram Panchayat. And that would be, they've de-puzzled some of these problems. The state went all the way to declare that broadband is an essential service. And this network which you are going to build is of a vital importance of citizens' experiences. They've enacted that. And thereby, the entire permissions have come from one stroke. Of course, there will be some operational challenges, but this is a step forward towards making some of the reformation challenges. We were also dealing with some of the utilities, and we found that there are 3-4 agencies in the country has some information about what is underground, but not good enough. Now, what if we combine all of that agencies which are currently probably driven by government? There is a different departments actually gather information for different purposes, but they remain in piecemeal. What if Department Telecom actually initiate a kind of a process where they can actually assimilate all these databases together and create a national database for the GIS mapping, and mandate everyone who's digging the road today for putting up any network, whether it could be telecom, utility, power, mandated to go to that central GIS portal. That is something that we can create a next future. So I think there are many things that we think we can provide in terms of skilling, certification, which is very important. We have an academy. I think we'll be most welcome to see some of you want to send your skilled people to get skilled. We believe the scale will only come if you train everyone in the field with the right requisite knowledge and the skills to deploy this network. I think when I'm saying that all of this, why this is relevant for us? As I said in the beginning, I think scale, latency, agility, there are three things which is very critical for us to look at it, because the networks which are going to be built for future are not one which were built for last 20 years. The scale is 5x. So we all agreed that fiber is a backbone. So if you're digging once, make it future-proof. Look for high fiber counts. There are options, which is once for all. The country should not repeat what we have done for last 25 years. It is important to realize this thing that if you're digging once, dig once forever. And I think a lot of technologies are coming in terms of you have to address latency. I know that we talked about virtual reality, artificial intelligence, all of this would require a significant addressing the latency part of the network. And some thought process already going in the Indian telecom system, I am aware of that, looking at densified networks and flattened architecture, which is actually very interesting to see, because if you really wanted to address not only speed, but you also need to address the latency part and the bandwidth part both together, this something architecture will go through a change. I think some work is happening in terms of creating agility, moving the centralized control to software, basically network function redesigning. I think this is something that a design framework we would recommend that everyone must actively participate, both at policy, industry, and ecosystem level. I have a few suggestions for Mr. Sivashalam in terms of what we should do as a policy going forward. We are talking about, I think, building more infrastructure in the country. We built, I think India has about 4.5 million roads, and you need to build every year about 500,000 kilometers of road. There are a lot, 50,000 kilometers of roads every year. There are a lot of infrastructure getting created. I think there is a need to create synergy with utilities. I think putting up, wherever the new road is being built, if a utility channel can be created, and make it mandatory that there is a communication, the fiber is actually part of that, could be a very interesting, because that will solve at least the future needs of the country. Also, I think cities which are being built today do not have infrastructure. In fact, we have done some cities in smart city program. We found that knowledge level of the city administration is very, very limited. They don't understand the purpose of why this networks are being created and what's the use of that for future. We recommend that every city planning must have a broadband infrastructure expert, and at the planning stage itself, because that's something which today India doesn't have. Even the building codes do not mandate fiber as the key part of the building codes. There is certain intent is there in the housing policy, but it has not been implemented. I think these are the significant steps way forward that we must look at to make national digital communication policy implemented in the true spirit. And that's what I just wanted to, I thought of sharing my views. And so some of you know Sterlite, and so I'm very privileged to speak after Jio GigaFiber. That made my day, because fiber is going to be everywhere. Thank you very much.